Guys, I warned you about GNU DA. I warned you about these things. I told you, I even asked you the following question. And I said to you, have you ever seen this other organization such as your Freedom Under Law, your Helen Susan Foundation, your Ahmed Katranda Foundation, you name them, right? Have you ever seen all these Save SA organizations fighting a white person in this country? Is it crime when it is committed by black, but business when it is committed by white? Here is an example. House is now currently raising funds to fight everybody that was against his words, or when he says kafir, whatever. Nobody, have you noticed that the DA said nothing? Recently, this farmers killed black people and fed their bodies to pigs. Have you ever heard anything from DA or no AfriForum? Okay, leave that. The organizations that are saving the law and all the stuff, have you ever heard anything from them? No. But today, Helen Zille will tell you, Sharpest JSC appointment is obviously extraordinary conflict of interest. What is not conflict of interest? I asked. Because you don't care about any white person that violates the law. You care about black people violating the law. Institutionalized racism is still alive. And I want to say this categorically clear, that I'm not saying every person who has a white skin is racist. I mean, the apartment I live in, organized, arranged, and everything by a white person. The estate manager here is white, is a white person. So I've never faced racism from those people. I'll be lying if I say I face racism. So in fact, my front opposite neighbor is a white person. Well, my other neighbor is an Indian. The other one is white. And where I live, I've got a lot of white people. But I can't say just because they are white, then they are racist. I usually pass them, you know. We pass each other when we leave the estate. I have never encountered racism, though I live with people who are white, Indians, and you know what I'm saying? I've never encountered that. So I am not saying everybody is racist by the virtue of the color. What is racist is the behavior. That's it. So if you are white, well, we're not talking to you as long as you are not racist. We're just talking to those with the behavior that is disgusting. And I want to put that categorically clear, because in this YouTube channel, you have white people who are watching my videos. You know what I'm saying? Oh, speaking about that, there's a video of Helen Zille. I'm sure she's going to look at this video. She's like, who's this dog? Who's this guy who's saying I'm not saying? Yeah, I've got a video. So I'm going to play a video of Helen Zille here. Don't worry. Just give me a moment. Right. Just a few minutes. Right. Before saying, yeah. All right. So yeah, we'll talk about that. But before we can proceed, guys, let's pay the bills, pal. This is what you need to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So, the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay. So, as we proceed, I have a problem with those organizations, but I want to play you a video. Go ahead and zile. Paparazing. Yeah. This decision is this and... And I'm like, yeah, batung. Why is it that the law has eyes, ears, and color? Guys, I mean, I'm against the black person who steals. I'm also against the white person who steals. Indian who steals. A colored person who steals. I'm against all of them. Right? The problem here, you must distinguish your problem. Your problem is not a color of a skin. Your problem is a behavior. As long as the behavior is good, black, white, Indian, colored, doesn't matter. You love them because the behavior is... Speaking about that, Listen to what she said. Here.
Dr. Hlophe, the former judge president of the Western Cape, was impeached after a 16-year battle started by myself as premier of the Western Cape back in the day. Started by us because he attempted, against his oath of office, to influence judges of the Constitutional Court to rule in favor of Jacob Zuma. Now, a more egregious and extreme case of judicial misconduct would be hard to find. And so, while we respect the fact that MK, in terms of the law, has a right to nominate someone to sit on the Judicial Service Commission that chooses judges, we contest the fact that they may choose someone who has such a profound conflict of interests. MK has argued that we cannot quibble or second-guess their choice for the Judicial Service Commission. And they say that Parliament has designated him, in fact, to serve on the Judicial Service Commission. The critical, pioneering, precedent-setting issue before this court is whether someone who is so entirely compromised and was seen as unfit and improper to serve as a judge should be allowed to be in a position where they interview and select judges. We believe that this is a watershed case for South Africa, and it will go down in history as the case that either defended the independence of the judiciary or compromised it.
Okay. All right, let's proceed. Helen Zilege, just to sum it up, this is so sad, though. This is hypocrisy at the highest level, right? Helen Zille said Thursday that it was irrational for the judge, for an impeached judge, for gross misconduct to serve on a body overseeing judicial process. The parliament impeached former Western Cape judge, local president, in February after the Judicial Service Commission found him guilty of gross misconduct. The judge stemmed from his attempt in 2008 to influence two constitutional court judges to rule in favor of former President Jacob Zuma in arms deal corruption case. Hlophe, who is now a member of parliament, was nominated for the JSC by political party Umkhonto weSizwe. Speaking ahead of the start of a court proceeding, Zille said Hlophe's appointment to the JSC sows distrust in their parliamentary process. House sows what? Yes, so what? Because we don't know, we have never been told, because the DA suspended him, but we have never been told what happened. Why was he brought back? What is it that they found? Nothing, right? So when it hosts nothing. I just want to find out. That's why I'm saying, when it's a black person, hey, mm-mm, thing tool. Someone who was impeached and dismissed by Parliament because of gross misconduct committed as a judge will now be interviewing and determining who should be judges in this and other court in South Africa. This is obviously extraordinary conflict of interest. We believe that this is a watershed case for South Africa and will go down in history as a case that either defended the independence of the judicial or compromised it. This is a matter that will affect every local anyone whosoever has a family member who appears before court of law. Oh, okay. I mean, I'm just wondering. All these things that you are hearing, that you hear them talking about, it is only applicable to certain people of color. But when it comes to others, no. Hi, we'll deal with this ones the our way. Their behavior doesn't affect people. Nobody remembers that, you behave this way. Hey, it's racist, man. We can't have you here. Hey, man. It's going to affect the perception and the trust of people. Because it's them. Hey, nothing is going to happen. People will trust that anyway. Hey, yay, no talk. Yay, Nina, no people, my hypocrites. Yay, Nina, yay, Nina. Nayibona le DA yenu, ngankhuza ngayo kwaseqaleni. Ho, lama clever blacks. Buka, yile. Is it corruption when it is black? Business when it is white? Tell me something. Is it corruption when it is black? Business when it is white? If really you trust the DA is gonna bring change, the DA is gonna bring change. All right, fine. Fair. Let's assume it the will, the change that you want. If really you trust them that way, to that extent, please tell me something. Why is it that in their approach, like we must look at cases they bring before court. Why is that? Majority of time it has got to do with color. It has got nothing to do with the law itself. Yes, it is phrased as saving SA, saving, but really, have you noticed that the cases that they bring in court, it's against certain color? Let me teach you something. You see, a person who doesn't care about color of a skin, but care about the law, is a person who says, whether you are Indian, once you violate the law, I will deal with you. Whether you are a colored, once you violate the law, I will deal with you. Whether you are a white person, once you violate the law, I'm going to deal with you. You are a black person, you violate the law, I'm going to deal with you. That is such is a person who really has a best interest of this constitution and this country at heart. The others, they are acting. Forget about their local. In fact, I must tell you this, that they qualify to act on a Hollywood movie because really, they make it sound like it's about the constitution. We are saving the country. Saving it from what? From black people. Saving it from what? Why are they quiet when it affects them? Why are they quiet in matters that directly affects them? Or one of their own? They are always quiet. I asked you, and I'm still going to ask you now. These farmers killed a black person, black people, give their bodies to pigs. Have you ever seen even a statement from Afrifron? No. Statement from DA? No. Statement from Save SA? No. Freedom Under Law? No. Helen Susan Foundation? No. Ahmed Gatrand? No. Sazwa Palampas' organization. Have you ever had a statement from those organizations? No. But when Sloppy was brought to court, no, we want to be the friends of the court. Yeah, we need to save our constitution. Hi, our constitution this. Hi, our constitution that. Yeah, it appears like the constitution must be saved from black folks. Be careful. We are being misled broad daylight here. There is a problem. I'm telling you, there is a problem. Here, believe you me, there's a problem. Khona okunuka santungwana nje, understand? Khona nje ukushaya amanzi la. La angazi yini. Kodwa nje khona okungekho right la. And believe you me when I say khona okungekho right la. Something is off here. But ke ngoba vele ke some of you guys you are overeducated. So cha das kuba lesileni silaba yiso leso. Ngathi ke wena uthi hayi wena bongani shangana sikhulunywa kanja hey ngiyazama na ungantolobeli ngiyazama namla ngantolobeli athi wena bongani usithukeleni le video yakho hey nabulabula ngofu na so ngantolobeli athi nitaguba. Hey guys, I'm lady. You know what I'm saying? I'm lady. You see? Mawukubona strategy ungifundise ishangana, ngifundise isuthu yabo. Hayi lento ukuthi ningibuke nje. Nithi awuzozibona. Hayi, isebenzi kanjalo. How? What type of an African who doesn't teach another African? My God, you must teach me these things, man. I must know, you know what I'm saying? Na mina ni ngishade umloko. Yebo lapha lapha lapha. Lapha phakathi phakathi eGiyani. Tingtule. Ngaze ngiveze imfihlo zami.